Welcome to Thalir. This is a place called Bud. This is budding forth for a new life, and we are Capuchins working for the renewal of the society and the church.
Dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, welcome to the Capuchin Online Ministries. This is the section for Sunday video messages. We are very happy to have Reverend Brother Augustine to give us the divine message today, the 4th of October. Father Augustine has been a great missionary in the North African country of Djibouti for 7 years. Again, he offered his service as a missionary in France for 7 more years. He has been a great formator. He has been a rector in a major seminary and minor seminaries for the Capuchins. He has also served as the parish priest. Presently, he is the superior of the community, the provincialate community of the Capuchins. Excellent preacher, known for his monthly recollections, as a committed priest. Here comes Reverend Brother Augustine Capuchin.
Dear brothers and sisters, today's gospel parable on the vineyard and the tenants reminds us that we are just stewards and God is the owner. The tenants, with their greed, behaved as if they were the owners. Gandhi once said, "The world has enough and more to meet the need of all, but not to the greed of any." Our consumerist and exploitative approach to persons, things, and the creation has led to the degradation of all creation. Today, the Church remembers and celebrates the feast of Saint Francis of Assisi, who is the patron of ecology and who considers the whole of creation as God's free gift to mankind. He was more conscious about this gift of God and was able to see God's presence in them. Such was his love and reverence to the universe. We are responsible to create and to recreate the universe and be thankful to the Lord for this greatest gift. We are invited to share the fruits of the universe with one another. God has entrusted to us this universe for this purpose. There are times when all of us try to put ourselves in God's seat. There are times when all of us act as if the world is ours and we are supreme over all we survey. We forget that everything we have is on loan to us from God. We are only temporary tenants on earth. We don't own anything, even though we sometimes act as if we own it all. Everything ultimately belongs to God. Pope Francis, quoting Saint Francis in his encyclical Laudato Si, calls for a conversion of heart in our approach to the whole creation. The story of the vineyard and the tenants reminds us that all is gift. As human beings, we have been generously gifted. As the human race, we have been given a great vineyard. We are called to respect creation as a wonderful gift. We are called to care for it well and to share its fruits generously. We are called to respect life, which is God's gift. We are called to welcome one another, especially the poor, the immigrant, the stranger. If each one is satisfied with what is essential and share the rest with others, our society and the entire creation would be protected with dignity. It is important to understand, whatever you have is not yours, but what you have given away. In other words, we have a responsibility to treat our gifts as gifts, things to be treated well, and things to be shared. Jesus tells a story to get his hearers to realize how they have not responsibly used the gifts they have been given. They have not given back to the Creator for what they have received materially and spiritually. The giver, the owner, God is disappointed. Some people go about trying to take advantage of others, of the society, and even of God. We see that in the parable of the rebellious farm managers in today's gospel, who enjoy the benefits that accrue to them as managers, but withhold the benefits that should go to the landowner. Today's gospel calls for responsibility and accountability in our dealings with God, which includes also our dealings with our fellow human beings. The common theme of today's readings is the necessity of bearing fruit in the Christian life and the consequent punishment for sterility, ingratitude, and wickedness. In today's first reading, the prophet Isaiah describes God's care of and expectations for his chosen people. God's chosen people have failed to bear fruit in spite of the blessings lavished upon them by a loving and forgiving God. Further, they have been poor tenants in the Lord's vineyard. Hence, God laments, "I expected my vineyard to yield good grapes. Why did it yield sour ones instead?" In the second reading, Paul tells Philippians about the high expectations he has for them, reminding them that they need to become fruit-producing Christians by praying and giving thanks and by practicing justice, purity, and graciousness in their lives. Jesus, in today's gospel, reminds us Christians that since we are the new Israel, enriched with additional blessings and provisions in the church, we are expected to show our gratitude to God by bearing fruits of the kingdom, fruits of the Holy Spirit in our lives. The parable has very important lessons for all of God's people in general. We all have at least received life from God. Life is given to us in trust. We are expected to cultivate and manage this life in such a way that it bears good fruit. Fruit that we can present to God, the owner of our lives, on the day of reckoning. The parable teaches us a lot about God and how God relates to us. First, we see the providence of God. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a fence around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a watchtower. Before God entrusts a responsibility to you, He makes provision for all that you will need in carrying out the responsibility. Then He leased it to tenants and went to another country. This shows God's trust in us. God does not stand looking over our shoulders, policing us to make sure we do the right thing. God leaves the job to us and goes on vacation to a far country, so to say. God trusts that we will do the right thing. But unfortunately, many of us don't. The story also highlights God's patience with us. God sends messenger after messenger to the rebellious managers who would not render to God what is his due. With each messenger, God provides another chance for us to put an end to rebellion and do the right thing. Finally, there comes a last chance. God plays his last card and sends his only son. If we miss this last chance, then we have missed it. In the end, we see God's judgment in which rebellious humanity lose their very lives and their privileges are transferred to others who are more promising. The picture is that of a provident, trusting, patient, but also just God. From this, we can learn a lot about ourselves and how we stand in a relation to God. First, we see human privilege. Like the managers of the vineyard, everything we have is a privilege and not a merit. This is what we mean when we say that everything is God's grace. Grace is unmerited favor. Another word for this is privilege. Life itself is a privilege which can be taken away from any of us at any moment. Privilege comes, however, with responsibility. We are ultimately responsible and accountable to God for the way we use or abuse our God-given privileges. God has given us all that we need to make a judicious use of all our privileges. Yet, we retain the ability to abuse them. This is called freedom. The parable of the wicked managers, as it is called, is a parable on the misuse of human freedom. Let us today pray for the wisdom and the courage never to abuse our privileges, but rather to make a judicious use of all the privileges and opportunities that God gives us. Few questions for our reflection and action. Number one, how concretely can I move from being greedy towards the needy? Number two, how effectively can I produce good fruit in the vineyard of the church through the Word of God, sacraments, Holy Eucharist, the role model of saints, etc. Number three, how effectively can I become a fruit producer in the vineyard of my family and society with my talents and skills through mutual sharing, sacrifice, love, and dignity? Number four, how effectively can I use the gifts of the world, the environment, the natural resources, etc. Amen. God bless you.